Let's continue building a universal web application with React. If you want to follow along, I recommend watching the prerequisite video first. So currently, we have server-side rendering with React already set up. However, the interactive features of our component does not seem to work. Why is that? Well, that's because our component's JavaScript was never mounted on the client side. React DOM server only spits out an HTML string. We'll need to build a JavaScript bundle that gets loaded on the page. But before we do that, we need to first configure a web server to serve static files. Let's stop the running server and open server.js. Since we're using Express, we can make our app use the express.static middleware and have it serve all files in the public directory. Let's save the file and then create a directory named public. We'll also create style.css to test that our middleware works. In the style sheet, we'll give the body some padding and then update the font. Save the file and open component.jsx. Since we'll be adding the style sheet to the head, we'll refactor our component to the full HTML markup. We'll move our existing code inside body. Now we can add a title. And we can also add our style sheet. Make sure to self-close the link tag, otherwise it's invalid in JSX. Now save the file, start the server, switch to the browser, and refresh the page. Nice. Our styles are applied and there's a React ID data attribute on every tag. Now that we know our static middleware is working, let's generate our client-side JavaScript bundle. There are many build tools that you can choose from, but I'll be using Webpack. So let's use npm to install Webpack globally. Once that's done, we also have to install Babel Core and Babel Loader, since we need to use that to transpile our JSX to JS. As a reminder, we already installed Babel Preset React, which is why it's not specified here. You can ignore the unmet peer dependency warning since we install Webpack globally. Now, let's create webpack.config.js, which is the configuration file that Webpack looks for when you run it. The configuration is simply a JavaScript object, so make sure you export it. First, add the entry point for the bundle. Let's set it to the relative path of client.js. Then let's configure the output of the compilation. Let's set the file name to bundle.js and the path to public. For those who are kind of confused, what Webpack will do is enter client.js, traverse through every require, and then build a bundle at public/bundle.js. Next, let's specify the module loaders. Our only loader will transpile JSX to JS. First, let's specify tests so our loaders only apply for files with an extension of JSX. Then we need to exclude the no modules folder so our loader doesn't get applied there. The loader is Babel Loader, which is what we just installed. And we'll use Babel Preset React as our query. Save the file and then create client.js. Now open the respective file. Here, let's require React, React DOM, and our component. Since this file will be loaded on the client side, we'll use React DOM to render our React element to the document. Remember that our component now returns the full HTML markup, so rendering to the top-level document node is valid. Otherwise, there'll be an invariant error. Let's save the file and open component.jsx. Here, we'll add the script right before the closing body tag. And we can self-close the script tag because JSX allows it. Let's save the file and return back to our command line. Run Webpack to generate the bundle and then start the server. Let's switch to our browser and refresh the page. Now, when we click the button, an alert pops up. Success! And that's all it takes to make our server-side rendered app universal.